Hi, and welcome back to our e-telecast, God Has a Word for You, and I'm Pastor Aminata. And now we're going to continue with the course of discipleship. And we are coming out of the book of St. Matthew's, or Matthew's, the 10th chapter, where Jesus is sending out his 12 disciples, and he's giving them instructions. And so we need to pay attention, because what we really want to come to an understanding, what he said to his disciples, would that apply to you and I today? I mean, was it just for back then, or ought we really pay attention to see if we understand the course of discipleship? So again, for those of you who can, get your Bible. Let's go back to Matthew's 10th chapter, and we're going to jump down now to verse 16. And this is what he says. He says, stay alert. He's telling his disciples to stay alert. This is hazardous work I'm assigning you. Okay, I know we need to pay attention now. You're going to be like sheep running through a wolf pack. So don't call attention to yourselves. Be as cunning as a snake, inoffensive as a dove. I want to stop right there and let's break that down. He said, this is hazardous work I'm assigning you to. Now, was that just for them then, or do you think by some chance that would apply to you and I today? I mean, would Jesus just be giving a message that's only in that context, only in that time, only to the disciples that were with him? Or do you think that it applies to us today? I mean, that's what the Bible is for, right? To give us instructions on how to live and how to serve. So I think we really ought to pay attention. And then when he says that we're going to be like sheep running through a wolf pack, I know that's right. I know. I mean, if you really are, I really want you to start, open up your eyes and start listening, paying attention. See what's going on around you in your world. I always use the expression, well, in my world, meaning in my community, in my neighborhood. Now, what's going on in my community, in my neighborhood, may not be happening in someone else's, but this is what's going on in my world. But what's going on in your world? So Jesus is sending out his disciples, and he wants them to be aware of what's going on around them. And then he says, but be as cunning as a snake, but yet inoffensive as doves. This goes contrary to everything that we see today. I mean, with the advent of our tele-evangelists and now the internet and the news, the secular news, they love it. They love it when some minister, some pastor, some preacher, some church, some organization give them something to write about. They take glory in sneering today's church. They take glory in bringing an offense to the name of Jesus Christ, and we help them. We help them. So we have to be as cunning as a snake, but yet inoffensive. We shouldn't be offending anybody in any way, but we should be sharing the gospel. We should be spreading the gospel. We should tell them that the kingdom is here, just like he said earlier on. That's our job, and we need to pay attention. The course of discipleship. So far, he said this is hazardous work I'm assigning you to. Are you ready to do that? Can you say, I'm committed, Lord? Doesn't matter. I'm still sold out for Jesus. What do you think? Or are you going to act like you didn't really know? You know, you never heard, and you know, you're going to go back on into doing what you do. Well, that's up to you. Anyway, I'll be back again. I'm Pastor Aminata. Hang with us. The course of discipleship. God has a word for you.
If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you're sincere and that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says in Romans chapter 10 that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and I need God in my life. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God who went to the cross to wash away my sin. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, I want you to email us and let us know, because right now you're saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and pray that God would lead you to a Bible-believing church where you can continue to grow in grace. God bless you.